Hi, welcome to Rose Hip Knits podcast episode 51. My name is Hanna and I'm recording this crafty, mostly knitting podcast from Northern Tasmania in Australia. Thank you for checking out this podcast. I've noticed there's been a few new people subscribing and checking out the podcast, so thank you for that, and thank you to all of those of you who keep coming back to join me when I sit down for some nice relaxing time. We have a group on Ravelry for this podcast, and you can find that just by searching for Rose Hip Knits podcast. At the moment we have a knit along happening there, a Aussie along, and this still a month to go on that knit along, so you're very welcome to join. I'm so happy to see all the projects in the finished object thread. The cow is basically to knit something out of Australian yarn, something by an Australian inter dyer, or knit a pattern by an Australian knitting designer or crochet designer. So easy. So many patterns and yarns that are just amazing, and there's free patterns by Australian designers that are beautiful that you can access from anywhere in the world, so everyone can join. And this jumper was sort of my contribution to the Aussie Along. One of them, I'll have more to show you. Okay, so that's the Ravelry group. I do have a blog. It's rosehipknitspodcast.blogspot.com, and I have been quite good with keeping up with posting the episodes there and some short show notes and links to things. I think last episode I still have not put up there. If you have any questions about anything, please put a comment down under here on YouTube, or send me a private message in Ravelry or a direct message on Instagram. I'm rosehipchick on Instagram and I'm rosehipchick on Ravelry, so you can always easily get hold of me. And I always appreciate any comments. Sitting here and recording and talking about my craft is just something that I really enjoy. It gives me a nice break, a nice time to reflect on things and just focus on me and my things, which is not something I get to do very often. So thank you all for joining me, and let's start talking about knitting. First, I should say that there's been, of course, quite a few things happening since I did my last episode, which was about a month ago. We in Tasmania had the Bothwell spinning, which is a, I think, biannual gathering for spinners. I think it's hosted by the Weavers and Spinners Guild of Tasmania, and it's held in Bothwell, which is quite a remote, rural, small place. So it's sort of southern part of the state, and yes, they have this gathering where there's a few market stalls, but it's mostly workshops and different spinning competitions and just people meeting and having a nice weekend together. So I went there this year, and last time I went, and the only other time that I have been there, was probably close to 10 years ago. When I went 10 years ago, I was quite new at spinning, and I think it was a larger event back then, but it could also be that I've been to Bendigo, the Australian Woolen Sheep Show now, so which is huge, so Bothwell just seemed very small this time. But it could be that it is smaller now than it used to be, I don't know. It is, it's a bit hard because it is quite remote, and to drive there is not, it's nice, it's out in the countryside and it's beautiful, but it's not sort of on the way anywhere or anything like that. So it's a bit out of the way, and I think that stops a lot of people from going there. And there's not really anything else to do in Bothwell. Anyway, I went there and it was just a great day to relax, had a look at the few stalls that were there, and at all the amazing displays that they had. I was very lucky to meet Katie of Knit and Stitch knit and stitch bits. And yes, it was lovely to see her and had a bit of a chat there. And yes, it was great. So hi, Katie. Thank you for coming up and saying hello. I did buy a couple of things and I might have to go and grab them a little bit later if I get the time to show you. It was very good. I didn't buy a lot. So that's one thing that's happened since last. Apart from that, as a family, we've tried to just enjoy the weekends and what has been left of our warm season. We had quite amazing weather for being the beginning of autumn. Summer was not great this year. It wasn't very warm. It wasn't great, but we had some amazing weather just like in the last few weeks. So we've tried to make a few road trips to different places and just being outside and enjoying what was left of summer. Today it's raining and windy and it really feels like an autumn day. So I'll start now with actually telling you what I'm wearing. And if you've seen the episode, my podcast before, you will probably realize. So today is the first day that I've been able to wear my newly finished flax sweater. And you might see that when the sun starts shining in, because it's still, the sun is still coming out every now and then, even though it's raining, it gets quite hot when the sun is coming in. But I am so happy with this jumper. So this is the flax sweater by Tin Can Knit, which is a free pattern. It's written for a worsted weight, I think about 18 or 19 stitches per 10 centimeters is for the gauge. What I used was the Bendigo Woolen Mills recycled wool that I bought when I went to Bendigo in July last year. Let's see if I have what's left. Yes. So it comes in 200 gram balls like this, and this is something that I found in the back room of Bendigo. So it's not something that you can purchase on their online website, so this is what I use, recycled fiber, an 8-ply, and it's not very soft. It is a bit scratchy. I can feel it here, that it does sort of scratch a bit. Not scratch, but I can feel it. But apart from that, it's fine. It's quite warm, really nice. I think I did the small size. It's all in my Ravelry project pages, and I should say that, I forget every time. You can find everything I talk about, all my projects, in my Ravelry project pages, and I'm Rose Hip Chick on Ravelry. So I think I did a small size, which was a size down from what I measured as, but my gauge was a little bit different, and because it has no shaping in the pattern, I thought I wanted it to be a nice tight fit to get that little bit of shaping anyway. And it did work out. I didn't make it really long because I wanted it sort of cut off my hip. But yes, it's a good fit. I really like it, and I think I'll make this pattern again and maybe just vary it a bit, maybe not do the garter on the sleeves, just make it as a simple, maybe do some other sort of texture pattern or something. All of Tin Can Knit's patterns are just so amazing and nice to knit. So I really recommend using their patterns, especially if you're not very experienced with a certain garment or knitting, then they are really good patterns that are easy to follow. Okay, well, let's have a sip of my tea. I am inside today in the sort of living area part of my kitchen. My three-year-old is somewhere in the house. I think she's emptying all the CD cases or something. She's doing something that's keeping her busy, so that makes me happy. And it's raining outside. We're just having a relaxing day. I've been doing a heap, mass of work this morning in bookkeeping, so it's nice to have this time now. So I've told you what I'm wearing, and we'll see if I have to take it off in a little bit if it gets too hot, but we'll see. So I now would like to share with you some knitting that I have finished since I last saw you. Something I was working on last time was my strata shawl by Shara Lambeth, and I have finished it. So this is this shawl. It's knit in a DK weight Polworth that I dyed. And I am a loose knitter, and I did not have enough for the last section. It was a while ago now that I finished, but from memory, this meant to be one of these sections here before the garter stitch border, and I just had to cut that out. And I think I was even so short of yarn, oh, I've woven in all the ends now so I can't tell, but I think I had to take a bit of my cast on tail to finish off the cast off. But I love it. I think it's a very nice pattern. It's fun to do all the different texture stitches. And yes, let's put it on and make me feel even hotter. So yes, it's great. This would be perfect autumn and winter outfit for me. Yes, I enjoyed it. It was something that was quite nice to work on when I wanted something more than just plain stockinette stitch or no, just garter stitch, but not too complicated. So that was my strata shawl by Shara, and I really like it. I like the colours. I think it came out beautifully, and yes, I'm looking forward to when it's a little bit colder and I can wear this. I think here in our climate, this would work quite well as an outer garment almost, instead of wearing a jacket. So that would work well. And yes, if I told you before that my three-year-old is at home and busy doing things in the house, but if I have to cut every now and then when I edit, it's because she's coming in to ask me questions and things like that. I hope it won't be too hard to watch the episode. Let's hope for the best. Another thing that I completed quite recently was a test knit by Tin Can Knits, or for Tin Can Knits, and Tin Can Knits was the designer of this jumper, and I have made a few test knits for them before, and you will have seen that if you've watched previous episodes. So they had a call out for a test knit for a hat and mittens that were set, and you could test knit either. So I decided on the mitts, and I can't remember now what this pattern is called once it was published, because it has been published now. But I'll put the information on the screen. And again, this is in my Ravelry project pages. So I made mittens. This is a child's mitten, so I can get it on my hand, but it is very tight on me. So for this test knit, I did what I always try to do when I do test knits, and that is to use something from my stash to knit it from. And this was some really deep stash. And I just had to put together the colours that I had in the right amounts. So it's definitely not what I would choose if I was going to buy new yarn to make this pattern from. But it works. See if I have the tags. Yeah, so this is a very old stash yarn called Magic Garden Buttons. And it's New Zealand yarn made for naturally handed yarns. And they're a DK weight, I believe. So they're these ones here. And then the darker purple is just some Spotlight 8-ply wool that I've had for a long time. And I had some scraps left of that. And yes, they're a bit fun, I guess. My daughter thinks they look like cupcakes and she's very happy. You only had to make one for the test, but I made the set, the pair of mittens. Because of my row gauge, they're a little bit long in the hand. Apart from that, they're a really good fit. And it's a good pattern. I can imagine these being knit up in lots of fun colour combinations. And they're easy knit, but they're interesting and fun. And then I had so much left of my yarn, and I still have this much left because I had one ball of this, I think, and two of this one. But because I had so much left and I didn't really know that I would use it for anything else, I made the matching hat that was part of the set that was also a test knit. So I made a child size hat in the same combination of colours to go with the mitten. So now my older daughter, she will have the set for when we go up the mountain for skiing and things this summer. This winter. So that's good. She's happy with that. And I think this yarn is quite good for sort of kids to wear. So it's 40 degrees mild machine wash. So it's pure New Zealand wool with a little bit of polyester effect yarn in it. So I think that will work well, and I'm so happy to have used it for my stash because it's just been sitting there since the time when I was working in a wool shop down in Hobart, so quite a while ago. So they're the other things that I have finished. Then I started and finished something else. I don't think I had started it last time. Last year, around this time I joined the Northamptonshire Knits podcast, the Mitten Along, or Mitten Cal. So Claire from New Hampshire Knits podcast, she did a colourwork mitten cal, and it was really popular, and she had a request to do it again this year, and so she did, and I think it finishes around now, because today is, I think it's the 28th of March, and it finishes end of this month. And I thought, okay, well, I really want to join the cow, but I wasn't sure that I would have the time to finish a pair of colourwork mittens in time. I think the cow was open for 6 weeks, but I thought I'll cast something on because at least I can sort of join in even if I don't finish. And I was going to use the pattern that I won last year when Claire had the giveaway for the mitten along, and that was the Songbird Mittens by Erica Hooser, I think her name is. But then at the same time there was another knit along starting, and that was by Stina of Bland Barn och Garn, which is a Swedish video podcast. And she, this year, she's come up with this really cool and clever idea of doing, somehow relating your project that you enter into the cow to the letter, first letter of the month. So she has a J cow going on. It goes all the way from, when goes from 1st of January, but then until the last day of the last month of the year that starts with a J, so that will be the end of July, I believe. Then she had an F cal, and that was only for February because that's the only month starting with an F. And then she started an M cal 1st of March, and that goes to the end of May, I believe, and that's how it would go through the year. So the MCAL had started, and I thought it would be fun to find a pair of mitts that starts with an M. And I have this great ebook called Vantar for alla årstider, which is Mittens for All Seasons, I think. And in that book was the Märta mittens. And I not only started these mittens, I finished them in not very long time. And I find it quite amazing because these are not just mittens. These are colourwork mittens, and they are flip-top colourwork mittens. And they are rather long. So this is one of them. And you can see this goes like, this is my elbow. Goes all the way up my arm. It's probably my row gauge again, that's a bit off. And it has the flip top. And I've put a beautiful wooden button on here that I bought in Talon a few years ago. So I made that for both of these cows. And as soon as I had finished one, I thought I better do another one, because otherwise I'm going to end up having different size mittens, because that's just how my life works. So I made another one, and I am so pleased. I again used what I had in my stash for these. So what I used was, sorry, I'm just looking here to see if I have the ball band, but I don't. This sort of dark avocado green is a Rauma Finul. And I think I found that in a like a bargain basket, but I can't remember where. Probably a yarn shop in Sweden when I went to visit. And I just had the one ball of that, and I thought, oh, I know that's great yarn. That's what I thought when I saw it, and I just grabbed it because I knew I would be able to use it at some time. And I knew that I had this lighter green one, which is also the same Rauma Finul. I had two balls of that, two 50 gram balls of that. That was part of a kit that my mum had bought me. The kit was for felted slippers or felted mittens, and I never got around to making them. And I was a bit hesitant to take some of the yarn from the kit to make something else, but I thought I'm more likely to use something like this, and it's better to use the yarn than to just have it sitting there for even longer. The red one is another bargain bin purchase, or maybe even an op shop purchase. It was really old, I think French yarn, and it was just 100% Shetland wool is what it said. And I think I put a picture of it in my stash in Ravelry. So that's what I used. And it's not the colours that I would choose if I would go out and buy yarn. But I think if I get to choose yarn from a yarn shop to make things, everything I make would be grey and purple and pink. So it's good when you're a bit restricted sometimes. So these ones I entered into both of those cows, the Märta, the M cow, and the Mitten cow. And now I have to wait a couple of days before I can start my A project for April, but also have not done a J project yet, but I have until the end of July. But I'm really hooked on these cows now, Stina, so yes. Watch out. So that's them. They're blocked and everything. All the ends are woven in, which is like amazing because there were just heaps and heaps of ends. So we'll see if it gets cold enough here for me to be able to use them. Then there was another cow that is a year-long cow that I'm trying to keep up with, and that's the One More Row podcast. They have a one gain cow, I think 12 in 17, so each month you're meant to make a project out of one skein, previous to this year, I have only made socks. You need to make a project from at least 50 grams and it can only be from one skein. So I have done socks for January and February, and I had finished the mittens and I thought, oh, can I quickly finish a one skein project for this month? And I remember that I had a skein of yarbu multikragi. Yarbu is the Swedish yarn brand, and the ragi is their like thick sock yarn. I think it's even have a thinner one as well. Anyway, I had a skein of, I think it's an Aran weight sock yarn that I purchased in Sweden a while ago, and I made these in a couple of days, I think. Again, all the details for stitch counts and things like that are on my Ravelry project pages. Obviously they're not matching up because you don't get a lot of yardage when it's Aran weight in 100 grams, and I used basically all of the yarn, and I made one and then I made the other one, so I kept the stitches open just to see if I needed to add on more at the end, but I didn't have to do that. I sort of estimated correctly and weighed correctly to get to socks of the same size. I used a fish lips kiss heel and made them toe up, and they are nice and thick and really nice just for having either at the ski lodge or just at home when the floor is a bit colder in winter. So that was my one skein project for March. I find that because I don't really need anything when I'm knitting, and I have probably talked about this before, I don't really need anything. I have more shawls than I can wear. I don't need a lot of knitted jumpers, and I can't knit a lot of knitted jumpers anyway because it's just too time consuming. I have masses of socks and I don't really need a lot of socks. I don't wear them except for when I'm at home, but I love knitting them. But doing the test knits and doing the cowl sort of just pushes me to use up yarn and to try new things and do different things without putting too much thought into it. I just have to start a project that fits within the cowl, and it keeps me making things and being happy with creating things. And if it ends up being something that it's not for me, then I am happy to give it away as a present to someone. So that's good. Let's see. Those things are things that I have finished since last time. Now that I have finished quite a few things, I'm trying to not cast on too many new things. I'm trying to work on what I already have on the needles, and I have a few things that I have had on my needles for a while. One of the things is a pair of socks, and I have put a couple of more repeats on here. These are a pair of colorwork socks from the book I showed you a few episodes ago, Tant Ultus Sokkor, and that's also now available in English actually. And if you go to my Instagram account, you can see that I've reposted the picture of the book when it came out in English. So you'll be able to get the details from there. So I've just put in another couple of repeats on these ones. And as you could see, I'm knitting them inside out because I found that I sometimes was knitting a little bit tightly. And I can see here now, it's like one of the repeats, I just knitted a lot tighter than the other repeats. I think it's this one here. It's like the second one I did. Which means that it is a little bit of a squeeze to get them over my heel. It does work, but yes, I'm just trying to make sure that it gets looser from now on. And yes, I'm just YouTube, and then just do a repeat when I feel like it. So they're the full-sail socks. Yes, I'm not in a hurry to get them done. They're just something fun to have on the needles. I don't think I'll make the leg. Maybe another two repeats, and that's it. And then I'll do the heel. And yes, but it's a nice knit because it's definitely not complicated, but it does take a little bit more of your brain when you have to keep track of the color changes. And I try to keep my floats quite short, so I do twist the yarn when this one color is more than like four stitches. So it's a bit of yarn management happening in that project, and that's not what I'm always in the mood for. But I have worked a little bit on that. Another thing that I have been working quite a bit on actually is my sway shawl, which is a crochet design by Deanne Ramsey, who is Adaday Designs. And this is it. And if you have seen this pattern before, you can see that I have made a mistake. This third wedge bit here in the third color is meant to be sitting under the two first wedges. So it's meant to be sitting here. When I discovered this, and I was sure that it was meant to be two on one side and one on the other side, but that was just in my brain. For how my brain works, that would sort of balance it out somehow and make it an even shape, but that's not the case. So when I had a look again at the photos, I could see that I had made a mistake. I do think that there was another project on Ravelry where the same mistake had been done, because I'm pretty sure that I saw a shawl that looks like mine, but I'm not 100% sure. Anyway, it's still a nice shape, but I think that it has made it a lot longer than the original. But I don't mind, because when I have tried it on, and it actually sits quite nicely around my neck. I guess it's more like a scarf when it's this longer shape. But I do quite like it still. You'll have the light on one side and the darker on the other side. And now I'm working on the darker color as a border, so it's going to be quite a deep border of this darker color. The yarn that I'm using is the blue one as my main color, which is a Dreamtime, Patent's Dreamtime, which was a sort of baby blue that I over dyed to a bit darker tonal blue. Oh, I'm all tangled up now. And then this lighter beigey brown color was a skein of my Oss sock that I had dyed up. And then the browny reddish color that I'm working on at the moment, and I'm tangled in with, and that is a skein that was a gift from Melinda of Yonder Woman podcast, and it's this one, and it's Elements Superfine Merino. And I didn't know this when I started crocheting with it, that it's sort of a, not a gradient, but it has long color repeats. It is has like one main color, but then the color that it's twisted with or spun with is a different color. I'm not sure if that's the correct way of describing it, but you can see there how it changes. So it means here, which was quite cool, that here it went from sort of dark purple maroon to browny yellow and then changed here again to another, like it's, you see how the color is shifting? So we're quite interesting to see what happens here. Because the rows are quite long, so I think I'll definitely get a few color changes happening in that border. So yes, I have another 6 rows or so to do. And then if I do the same, if I do the same number of rows as the pattern, then that will be complete. So that will be lots of fun. I'm looking forward to being able to wear that. And I've been having a lot of fun crocheting. I thought that crocheting would be faster than knitting. I seem to remember it being very quick from when I used to do a lot of crocheting. And everyone keeps saying that crocheting is faster and uses up more yarn. But I must say that this one is taking me quite a bit of time. And I don't know if it's because it's the half double crochet, I think that's the main stitch in the shawl. And it's just not growing very much with that stitch. But it's a beautiful finish to it. So that's been a really good take along project as well, because it's easy to just, it's basically the same stitch most of the time, except for the wedges. They're just sort of shorter rows, but still not difficult. You have to maybe keep track of your stitches a little bit more, but no, it's been really good project to pick up and work on a little bit every now and then. What else am I working on at the moment? Oh, I still have my pre-lean cardigan that I haven't touched, so let's not talk about that one. I don't know why I mentioned it. Just yesterday, I cast on a new project, and I know I shouldn't, but this is a test knit for Shara, and I saw her shawl design on her latest podcast, and I thought that was looking pretty cool, and it's a brioche pattern, and I have never even touched brioche. I have never watched a brioche tutorial. I've never read a brioche pattern. I have never seen brioche in real life that I know. So I asked Chiara when she asked for test knitters if she was interested in someone who was a total newbie to brioche. And she said yes, which was great. So I started her Fernshawe shawl, I think she calls it. It took me a few days to choose what yarns to use. I went through one of the most popular patterns on Ravelry that is a brioche pattern. I think it's a Pearl Soho cowl. I went through, and there's like thousands of projects. I went through a lot of those projects to look at different color combinations. And I found that I didn't like when there was too much of a difference, like a white and a black, or a really pale something and a really dark something. And when I looked in my stash, I had a lot of pink and purples, of course. And they were just a bit, the ones that would go together were just a little bit too different in, like one was very light and one was very dark. Anyway, in the end, I went for something that was totally out of what I normally do. Again, it's a theme. And I have decided on these two. And I'm sorry, the sun's definitely not out anymore. And I'm hoping you can see okay. This is a skein, Spoil Sock by Sandra of Craftfulness podcast and Etsy shop. I have a few of her skeins and a few of her project bags, and I love them all. This is from my last purchase from her, when I think it's called Citrus Fall Fruits. Fall Fruits. I purchased this from her because I thought I have nothing like this in my stash. And I was just feeling like yellow and mustardy would sort of, it was something that I needed in my life. So I bought that. And this blue and purple and red skein I bought from, I have a tag here, Janet from My Spin on Things. And she had a stall at Bendigo last year, not at the actual showgrounds, but they had a separate smaller market in the bowling club. I think think it was. So she had a stall there, and I bought some bats from her and some other things, beautiful things. And this was just a skein in her sort of bargain basket for, I think, $15 or something. And I talked to her because it didn't have a label on it, but she said it was a sock yarn. And I think it's a wool nylon blend. And I think these two would be pretty cool. And I have made one repeat on the shawl. And this is what it looks like from that side, and this is what it looks like from that side. I am thinking about maybe ripping it out and starting again with a smaller needle size. I'm using a 3.5 millimeter, but I have no clue what the fabric is meant to be like. It's thick and squishy, but it does seem to be very holey. I don't know. I'll think a couple of more days, maybe, or one day, and then I'll decide what to do. Shara suggested that maybe I should just go down a needle size from here and see what it looks like, so I might do that. I really like how the colours are coming out. Yes, and what I did was I just started, because I'm totally new to this, but I just started following Shara's pattern. There was one stitch that I was a bit unsure about, and I watched a tutorial that Shara had linked to. But the problem was that they were knitting not continental like me, or I don't think so anyway, but they just had a different way of knitting. So I got a bit confused, but I figured out that stitch by watching some tutorials. But then I decided I just won't watch other people do it anymore. I'll just follow the instructions that Shara has in the pattern, because she describes the stitches sort of in words, and I was able to just follow that and get it right. So that's fun. So that's my new adventures in brioche. So that's lots of fun, and I'm looking forward to knitting more on that. And that's I think all that I have been working on. Apart from all the knitting that I have been able to find time for, I have been doing a little bit of dyeing again. I had a long break from dyeing, again, different reasons, and then I felt like it was time to start again, and I was able to do some dyeing again, so I did that. And I can show you that, because that's part of something that I've been working on and actually finished. I made two new self-striping colorways, and I have two skeins each of this. They don't have a name or anything, because I have been working on my pirate socks, and I think I call them pirate socks because, you know, mainly I'm using my pirate project bag from Give Me a Crown, Nina. But also I think crazy socks like this is something that a pirate would wear. It's a bit adventurous, it's a bit out of the box, it's a bit rebellious. So I think that's like a pirate. So these are my pirate socks, and I have knit them from all the different striped colorways that I have dyed up and I've had in my shop. I think this one is still available. This one and that. Also, yes, they're the old ones that I have some of. So with the new ones, this is the new one, one of the new ones, and this is the other new one. So I needed these two colorways to be able to complete my socks. So they've been hanging around for a bit waiting for me to dye that up. So those, and then I had, I wasn't sure about the heels and toes, but I decided to just go with the same self-striping all the way to the finish. These were afterthought heel socks, knitted from the top and down. And then I decided for the heels to just use what I had more leftovers from. So for this heel, I used this one from this sock, and for this heel, I used this one from this sock. So they have, the heels are from the other sock. I'm so happy with these. I don't think I'll be wearing them anytime soon because I thought they're quite a cool sample knit. Sample both for me, for my sort of, for my dyeing, but also for me to see how I've sort of developed and what I have done. But also something if I go to a market at any point, something that I can show. So, they're the pirate socks, all done. I haven't woven in the ends. So on my afterthought heels, they need to be stitched up a little bit because I didn't do too well with picking up stitches. But I love them. And I think I'll have to make some more. So there's self-striping. So other little samples I have made, because I dyed up some more of my Oss sock, and I started with one of them, I started on another sock, just a sample, but I only had about 3 grams of a sample skein, so I didn't make it very far. And then I thought, this might not sort of be good enough of a representation to show customers. You can see this one sort of gets a bit stripe on one side and then just a bit like that on the other side. So then with another colourway that I have, a new colourway I have dyed up, I tried to just make a little swatch. And that's that one. But then I thought, really, this is not really showing much. You see, this looks a bit crazy. But if you knit a sock from this, it will look completely different. If you knit a shawl, it will look completely different. It will not at all have this sort of half striping. It would probably look more like this one. Because if we look at the skeins, which I have here, both these colorways are dyed with sort of blocks of color. So this has a block of purple, a block of yellow, and 2 blocks of greens in between. And this one has a block of yellow, a block of pink, and then sort of a bluey grayish in between. So that's very similar. Oops. In the way that the colors are divided on the skein. So I think they would look quite similar knitted up, the way the color is distributing. So my 2 swatches shows quite different result, but they're just completely different samples of what it will look like. So I don't know, how do you like seeing things knitted up? Because what I thought, I really like to just make socks so that I can, it's actually an item at the end of it. So first I thought I'll just sort of continue with the next colorway, but then I thought it might not be enough to take a photo of. But then I don't know, is this worthwhile? Like, will anyone just use the yarn to make little squares? And unless you're making little squares, it's not going to look like this. So I'm not sure. I'm happy for any sort of suggestions or any ideas. But I have those 2 new colorways, which was just like, I needed a bit of color and fun. So I have those on the Oss sock. When I did those, I also did a sort of tonal purple and sort of raspberry pink, and I also did a red, and it has a bit of a yellow undertone in places. So these 2 are dyed by layering of colors, whereas these 2 was just sort of colors in 3 different areas of the skein and some blending doing that. But these ones I did several dye baths, sort of 1 dye bath that was absorbed, and then the next one, and then the next one. So it just gives it a really deep color. I really love these. It's so fun to see them when they're drying and see what the end result will be. Yes, so I have two each of all of those. And then I just did some of the New Zealand sock yarn too. Just had some fun doing some sort of speckling and blotching. But the main thing that I've sort of been planning and thinking about has been some 5-ply superwash wool, Australian wool, that I've had for a while. It was something I purchased a while ago, but I only had 8 100-gram skeins. So I wasn't sure if it was something I was going to dye up for the shop or something I was going to dye up for a, like, for a jumper for myself. But then looking at mittens, when I made my Mata mittens, and looking at different one skein projects, I found some mitten patterns that uses a 5-ply and that I quite liked. And I thought, oh, I should just dye up a skein of these 5-ply wool to 5-ply yarns to make mittens. And I thought, maybe I should just do a few different colorways that I would love seeing as mittens, and then just choose one colorway myself and then put the rest in the shop. And the ones that I want to make are the simple autumn mittens. And you probably won't be able to see this very well. I can see all the reflections. I might put it in a photo on the screen, we'll see. But they take a sport weight yarn, and the gauge on the pattern is similar to what's recommended on the yarn from the manufacturer. So I made 4 different colorways, and I have 2 of each, and I think these will look amazing as mittens. And I'm just going to have to choose which one of them that I am going to make mittens from. I'm going to make a gauge swatch and see if I end up with the same gauge as this pattern, the simple autumn mittens, or have a few other mittens in my queue that might be suitable. So I'll show you this one. And these again are with layers of color. And here they are. So let's see. I made my raindrops colorway because I thought it's one of my first colorways and one of my absolute favorites, and I don't have anything for myself in this colorway. So I might choose that, but then I made some other ones that I really like too. But I have that one. Another one I made is sort of a, I guess it's a grello, but I don't know, is grello a greeny, a greyish yellow, or is grello grey and yellow together, but different colours? I'm not sure. But that's that one. 2 skeins of that, and that's something that I will never ever use normally, but that makes me really want to make mittens out of it, so I don't know. And then I wanted a sort of a purpley pink, dusky pink, I don't know, plum color, so I did that. And then I wanted a sort of a greeny color, and I did this one, and I love them all. And I think they all go beautiful together. And I think I have to make these colorways on other yarn as well. I'm really happy with how this sport weight dyed up. It's 100% Australian wool, but it's machine washable. I really like it. I think it's perfect sort of mitten. It's not super soft. It's not merino soft, but it's probably softer than what this is. I think it's perfect for mittens and hats and things like that. So yes, I have to list them on my Etsy shop, and I have to choose which one I want to use. And I wish I could get hold of more of this yarn, but I don't think that I can. And that's that. Oh, I had another one of the Osok, this one here, which is, I think it will be a micro stripe, I think they call them, where you get just very small stripes because it's sort of a half-half skein. Half dark grey and half speckled. have two of those as well. So yes, I did a bit of dyeing, had lots of fun doing that. I have a lot more planned that I want to do. I just now need some time to take photos and upload to Etsy and do all that sort of admin stuff. Okay. I think that's all. I have a few things written down that I could talk about, but I think this episode is quite long enough. The sun's out again, it's getting warm. It's getting close to when the rest of the family comes back home after a day of work and school. So it's probably time to finish up. I've actually, for the first time in a very, very long time, I've managed to get down to 0 videos in my watch list on YouTube. It's crazy. I had a bit of a talk to myself about this, and I said, don't be ridiculous, Hanna. You can't, like, it's a full-time job if you're going to watch every episode of every podcast that you want to watch. So I had to delete some older episodes of some podcasts and just watch more recent ones. And then I had a few sick days at home when I was able to, well, I wasn't able to do much more than watch, so I did that. And now I'm going to try to keep up, but also be reasonable and just watch things that I really like and try out some new things as well, because that's the thing, if you're so busy watching everything you want to, you don't have time to watch anything. So I'm going to try to get time for that, and if I miss an episode here or there, it's not the end of the world. Okay, that's it. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please join our Aussie along, and I have some really great prizes for that. And yes, any comments are very welcome. I'm getting a bit hot again, as you can see, so I better go and take this jumper off. Oh, last thing, really good news. I am going to Bendigo again this year. So in July, I, with my family, are going on the ferry across to Melbourne and then on to Bendigo to go to the Australian Sheep and Wool Show. So, oh, I'm looking forward to that. So as you can see, I'm knitting down my Bendigo haul from last year. This was part of that. And a few other things that I've been working on, but I don't know where they are. Oh, yes. Anyway, I also have to do some spinning. I have to do lots of spinning. Because I bought a lot of fiber last year. Yes, but if you're going to Bendigo, I really like to organize some sort of knitting catch up. So either at the showgrounds, I mean, it really depends on what the weather would be like, but it'd be fun to at some point just organize for people to just sit down, like, I don't know, grab a cup of coffee or something and come and sit down and have some knitting with you or something, and just sit down and talk and knit. Or if it's a way of meeting at a cafe, like the Friday afternoon or the library or something like that. I don't know if anything is being organized already, but I would really like to join something like that. I found last year that we did have a podcasters meetup, but we didn't really have a time to just sit down and actually do something. I need to, I think, work with something in my hands when I meet people, and just for the sort of nice relaxed feeling, and just really enjoying the moment and being there. And I was a bit stressed, and I was flying through all the stalls twice, I think, making sure I got to see everything. This time I'm going to excuse me, take it a bit easier, and I'll have my kids with me, so who knows what I'll be able to do. Okay, I'm losing my voice. I better say bye and see you next time. So take care, everyone, and I'll see you for the next episode. Bye.